In the last part of this lecture, I'm actually going to talk about an application of deep graph generative models to molecule generation, right? So basically, if you want to generate drug-like molecules, you can use graph generative models. So let me tell you about that. So the way we are going to do is the following. The question is, can we learn a model that can generate valid and realistic molecules that optimize some property, right? So the way you can think of it is that we want to have a model. The model is going to output a given molecule. This molecule has to be valid. Basically, it has to obey the rules of chemistry. It also has to be realistic, right? You cannot generate some Frankenstein-type molecule. It has to be realistic. It has to look like a drug. And we want it to optimize a given property. For example, we want it to optimize drug likeness. We want to optimize its solubility. And the paper I'm going to talk about, or the method, it's called Graph Convolutional Policy Network for Goal-Directed Molecular Graph Generation. And it's linked here, and you can read it if you want more details. So here is a high-level overview of this paper and of this novel problem of optimal molecule generation, right? The goal here is to generate graphs that optimize a given objective, like drug likeness, that obey underlying rules, meaning that the graphs are valid, like chemical validity rules, like the bonds and things like that, and are learned from examples, meaning they look realistic, right? They imitate molecular graphs which we use for training, right? And we just talked a bit about, you know, how do we imitate a given distribution of graphs. The difference is we don't want to only imitate, we want to generate graphs that are valid, and we want to generate graphs that actually optimize a given criteria, a given black box, right? And here the important point is that the criteria is really a black box, right? It's this black box where the graph generation will get some feedback, right? The objectives like drug likeness are governed by physical laws, which to us will kind of be assumed they are unknown. What do I mean by that is we don't need them to be written down. All we have to do is to have a black box. If we give it a molecule, the black box tells us how good that molecule is. But we don't have to look into the box. That's the important point. So how are we going to do this? We are going to do this and cast it as a reinforcement learning problem. And the way reinforcement learning, the way we formalize it is that we have a machine learning agent that observes the environment, takes an action to interact with the environment, and then receives a positive or negative reward. And then the agent wants to learn from this loop. And the key idea is that agent can directly learn from the environment, which is a black box to the agent, right? So we think that there is the environment, the agent is taking actions and it's interacting with the environment, and the environment is giving back some feedback, some rewards to the agent. And there are two types of the rewards. There is the instantaneous reward, and then there is the long-term reward, right? In our case, instantaneous reward will be, did I just, add an atom to the molecule and I did it according to the rules of chemistry? And then the long-term reward will be, after we are done with generating the molecule, how good was that molecule? That's the long-term reward. Okay, so the solution to this goal-directed molecule generation, we call it a graph convolutional policy network that combines graph representation and reinforcement learning. And the key component of GCPN is that we are going to use a graph neural network to capture the graph structure information. We are going to use reinforcement learning to guide the generation towards the desired objective. And we are going to use supervised learning to imitate examples on a given training data set, right? We want our molecules to look realistic. So how does GCPN differ from graph RNN? First, you know, what is the commonality? The commonality is that these are both generative models for graphs, and they try to kind of imitate or they can be learned given a data set. What are the main differences? Is that GCPN is going to use a graph neural network to predict the generation of the next action. While graph RNN is using the hidden state of an RNN to decide on the next action. And a graph neural network is more expressive than a recurrent neural network. So that's the benefit of the GCPN approach. But on the negative side, the GNN takes longer time to compute than an RNN. So molecules generally are small, so we can afford this more complex algorithm that has bigger expressive power and is able to learn more. So GCPN will then also use a reinforcement learning to direct graph generation towards our goal, towards our black box. And reinforcement learning will enable us this goal-directed graph generation. So to give you an idea, both of these two are both GCPN and graph RNN are sequential graph generation approaches. But in the graph RNN, we predict the action based on the RNN hidden state, right? So the node gives the hidden state to the edge level RNN, and then the hidden state is passed on, and the edges are generated, and then the hidden state goes back to the node level RNN, right? So basically, all the information, all the history is captured in this hidden step, hidden state. And if you have generated, I don't know, 10,000 nodes, this means this hidden state has been transformed 10,000 times, and then for every edge, it's also been transformed. So you need it's a lot that this hidden state needs to capture. So in a GCPN, we won't have this notion of a hidden state, but we are going to use the GNN to basically give me the embeddings of the nodes. So I'm going to say, here is a partially generated graph and here is a new node. What I'm going to do is I'm going to embed each of the nodes in the partially generated graph, and then I'm also going to have some embedding for the new node number 4. And then based on these embeddings, I'm now going to predict which node number 4 should link to, right? So this means that basically now I'm not using the RNN to do this, but I'm using a graph neural network to generate the state, and then I'm simply doing link prediction. So I'm kind of using predicting potential links using node embeddings rather than to directly generate them based on the hidden state. That's the difference. And this will be much more scalable, much more expressive, much more robust, but less scalable because we have to now compute these embeddings and then evaluate these link predictions for every single edge. So the overview of GCPN is that it has these following four steps, right? First, we are going to insert the nodes. Then we are going to use the GNN to predict which nodes are going to connect with each other. Then we are going to take an action, and we are going to check chemical validity. And then if the action is correct, we say, yes, you created a good edge, you didn't create a good edge. And then after the model is done generating the graph, we are going to compute the final reward. We are going to ask the black box, you know, what do you think of the molecule we generated? So a few questions about the reward. We will have two rewards. One will be the award per step, which will be basically to whether the model has learned to take a valid action. Basically, at each step, a small positive reward will be awarded for taking a valid action. So basically, by respecting the rules of chemistry. And the final reward will be proportional to the goal is for it to optimize the desired property of the molecule, right? So at the end, we are going to get huge positive reward if the molecule is good, and a low reward or no reward if the molecule is bad, right? And the total reward is going to be final reward plus these stepwise rewards. And then in terms of training the model, there are two parts. First is the supervised training, where we are going to train the policy by imitating the actions given real observed graphs using the gradient. So basically here we are just kind of going to try to learn our model how to generate realistic molecules and not worry about optimizing their structure yet. So it's just about learning to generate proper molecules and obey chemistry. And then in the second part of the training, we are going to actually train a policy that optimizes the reward. And here we are going to use a standard policy gradient algorithm, you know, that is kind of classical in reinforcement learning. But the point is, we are going to have two steps of training, one to learn the chemistry, and then the second one to learn how to optimize the reward. And now if I want to show you this, right, we will have the partially generated graph. The GCPN is going to decide how to grow it one node at a time and how to create connections. We are going to get small positive reward and the gradient based on the fact that we have generated the graph correctly. And you know, this is going to loop until we decide the molecule is generated. Now that the molecule is generated, we are going to ask our black box to tell us how good is this molecule. And then, you know, this final reward is going to be also backpropagated, right? So this generation is going to be trained using the supervised learning, and then this overall end-to-end with the delayed reward will be trained in the this kind of reinforcement learning framework. And what is the benefit of this approach is that we can actually take we can generate molecules that try to optimize a given property. So here I'm showing you different molecules that optimize log P, which is a particular chemical property, or Q. Here we are optimizing QED, which is the quantum energy. Again, something that medicinal chemists worry about. And you can see how these graphs that we generate look like real molecules. Another thing that this allows you to do, it allows you to take a partially built molecule and complete it. So for example, you can start with some starting structure, where here log P, I think it's solubility, right? So basically you start with some very bad values of solubility, and then you say, how do I complete this structure to improve solubility? And here you see how it went from -8 to, you know, -0.7, and from -5 to -2 by basically completing the molecule. Right? So this is the point, is we can take basically a partially built structure or finish it, or create a brand new structure. So let me summarize the lecture of graph generation, right? So complex graphs can be successfully generated via sequential generation using deep learning. Each step is a decision that is made based on the hidden state, and this decision can either be implicit or explicit. In the RNN, this vector representation about keeping the state was implicit because it was all in this hidden state, while in the GCPN the state was explicit because it was computed directly on the intermediate graphs and encoded by a neural network. I also showed you possible tasks for graph RNN. We talked about imitating a given set of graphs, and for the second part, for GCPN, we talked about optimizing graphs to a given goal. I talked about the application to molecule generation to try to generate molecules with optimal properties. But you could apply this to any kind of graph generation task, to any kind of property. For example, you know, including generating realistic maps, generating realistic cities, road networks, materials, and things like that.